Hi everyone, it's time to talk about thumbnails. Thumbnails help you weed out the good ideas from the bad. They're a series of small drawings meant to explore ideas quickly and provide you with visual notes. They're the next step in our creative process. Remember, behind every great design is a journey. That journey includes time to prepare, ways to get inspired, and methods that will help you turn your ideas into great visual solutions. Thumbnails are always an important part of doing graphic design, and many times you'll be the only one to see them. Other times though, the art director or team that you're working with, they may need to see the thumbnails so that you can all brainstorm solutions together. Thumbnails are done in a variety of different ways. Some people, they like the super simple chicken scratch drawings, while others, they lean towards elaborate and beautiful sketches. There's benefits and drawbacks to both styles. On one hand, fast, loose drawings give your work breathing room and allow you very quickly to get many ideas on paper. Be careful not to rush so quickly that ideas and compositions can't be explored. After all, if you're not coming up with ideas and giving them some detail, you're kind of missing the point. On the other hand, elaborate thumbnails allow you to come up with more solutions. Caution, though, not to spend so much time on them that your work on a single thumbnail is restricting you from quickly exploring many ideas. If you're spending too much time on one idea, you're going to stifle your creativity. It's perfectly fine to get a bunch of thumbnails done and then go back later and work on your favorites a bit longer. And after completing your thumbnails, you're going to do larger and more detailed designs. These are called roughs. And roughs are the step that happen between the thumbnails and your final design. And we're going to talk more about those later. And because this is a beginning class, guys, some students will not be comfortable or familiar with drawing. Don't worry. You don't need to know how to draw. That's not what thumbnails are about, not in this class anyways. So, this video is meant to give you some thumbnail sketching basics. Let's move forward. First, let's take a quick look at some things to avoid. The first one is incorrect orientation. You need to use the format that your final work will be produced in. If your final design is going to be taller than it is wide, then it's called a vertical or portrait orientation. If it's wider, then it's called a horizontal or landscape orientation. Your thumbnails need to match that. Next, repeating the same thumbnail. Just moving around objects on the page isn't enough. Although it's important to try different compositions, you also need to explore different concepts. Avoid missing information. So if your final design needs to have a headline, text, imagery, all of those important things need to be included in the thumbnail. Don't be too messy. You don't need to know how to draw, but you do need to indicate legibly where objects in the page go. This way your thumbnail can address composition challenges. Don't spend too much time on any one thumbnail. It's also important to avoid grids. Grids allow thumbnails to start bleeding into one another, and this can result in them affecting each other, instead of each one being able to stand on its own. The image on the right has squares that are drawn in advance, and it does have margins around each of the thumbnails. This is better than a grid, but keep in mind, if you have a thumbnail that you're drawing and it needs to get a little bit larger, an object has to go out of the edges, or you have a lot of notes to take, there's not a lot of room left. My preference is to draw each thumbnail as I go along, allowing me enough room to make notes in the margins. Let's talk about some thumbnail basics and how to start them. First, different creative people have a variety of ways to do thumbnails, depending on their needs. So in this class, I'm going to focus on what's expected for our projects. Here are some basics. Remember to use your sketchbook. Taking a photo of your thumbnails in your sketchbook is going to be graded with each project. Depending on the size of your sketchbook, you can probably fit 6 to 12 on a page, roughly around 2 or 3 inches in size. What should you use? Well, most people use a pencil or a pen. I prefer a pencil personally because I can control the weight of the line. This helps me with contrast and focal points, and they're just more forgiving than pens. Many people like to use pens though, and that's perfectly fine. How many thumbnails should you do? Well, for this class, we need to do at least 10 with each project, and preferably more. What's important is to keep working until your ideas are thoroughly explored. And how do you actually start a thumbnail? You start with an outline of a box using the correct orientation. There are simple techniques you can use. Basic outlines for placement and movement are fine. If your design includes a landscape, then incorporate simple shapes like triangles for trees, rectangles for buildings. If you need humans in your composition, you can put circles for heads. You can use squiggly lines for text. You can keep it very simple as long as you're showing placement of where the objects and the elements in the page need to go. Using a pencil, I can begin sketching lightly and build up the line and build up the shapes. I can shade the backgrounds for negative or dark spaces if I want, and lines can be made darker to indicate focal points. The visuals we come up with need to reinforce the project mood and message. Sometimes headlines and slogans are really helpful in doing that. So, what exactly is the message? The message in the case of our project is given to us in the headline, up close with the black keys, or the black keys up close. Up close is really important. It's the key to coming up with visual solutions. The idea here is that the audience is going to be in a small, intimate venue with the band. Not far away in a huge stadium, like you see some concerts at, but really up close with the band. So we're using that idea to help sell tickets. In addition to the word saying up close, though, we need our visuals to somehow reflect that same message. And that kind of takes us to keywords. So, because we need to take more than just the headline into consideration, all of that preliminary work that you've done so far can help you come up with keywords, and keywords can help you come up with visual ideas also. So for the black keys, your design should reflect keywords like band, grunge, texture, muted colors, troubadour, glasses, casual, leather, jazz, rock and roll. Words that can help you focus the visuals in your design. And finally, sometimes it helps me to write down my headline and keywords next to my thumbnails to help keep me on track.